Hey, what is up everyone? Norman from Future Studio University here, and welcome to another video in our JSON series. In the last few videos, we have learned how JSON maps all kinds of data structures to Java objects and how it can serialize Java objects to JSON. In this video, we will look at a special case of null values. So how does JSON react when you pass null values during serialization? How does it handle null values during deserialization? And is there a way to change that default behavior? All of that you will learn in this video. You can find the code on GitHub and you can read everything in more detail on our website. I've linked both in the description below. So let's get started. So here we have a small sample of serialization and deserialization. Now these are examples from the first JSON video. You might want to watch that to better understand this one, but if not, that's okay too. What we have here is a user simple object. In the first few videos, we have always set all properties to some value, and JSON was able to map all of that. But now we change it a little bit and say, is developer? We don't know if he's a developer or not. We set that to null. And that's possible because the isDeveloper is a Boolean property which is nullable. So let's execute this and see what happens. So when we look at the resulting JSON here, we see that the isDeveloper isn't included. By default, JSON will completely ignore null values if we not include them in the JSON to keep it as small as possible. So what happens during deserialization? If you look at the JSON down here, I've skipped the age property. So it does not have the age property included, or essentially it is null. And what will happen is JSON will not throw an error. It will simply set the property that is not included in the JSON to null. So it sets the age to null because it's not included in the JSON. Now this is possible because the user simple class has defined the age as an integer, as a box integer. So it can set the value to null. But what happens if it's an int value, which is not nullable? So let's try this again and see what happens. And we will skip one further. And you can see that the user simple object now has an age value of 0. So again, JSON will not throw an error. It will try to do the best it can. And in this case, the default value of an integer is 0. But that means we need to be very careful here, because the object here does not say that age is 0. It says it doesn't know the age. Be very cautious when it comes to these default mappings. All right, now there is one more thing, and that is, how can you force the serialization of null values? Maybe your API expects that the values are explicitly set to null and not just missing. Now you can do that by changing JSON's default behavior. And what you need to do is you need to not use the standard JSON instance, you need to use a customized JSON instance. And you can do that with a JSON builder, and you can set serialize nulls on it and then create. So what is happening here is you have the JSON builder, you will customize that JSON instance to say, please serialize null values, and then we recreate this custom JSON instance. We will use this custom configured JSON instance then to create the JSON, and theoretically, we should now see that the isDeveloper is included, but explicitly set to null. And back here, you can see the isDeveloper is set to null. So this is how you can force JSON to serialize null values. That's it for this video. You have seen how JSON maps null values in both directions and how you can force JSON to serialize null values. Thanks for watching. If you want to support us, please give this video a like and subscribe for more videos. Enjoy coding and make it rock.